This week on Outdoor Bound TV, we travel to the famous Kenai River Peninsula of Alaska, where we meet Lee Kuepper and Paul Tornow, owners of Alaska's angling addiction and former northern Wisconsin residents who now call Alaska home. After a quick refresher on fly fishing techniques, we turn our focus to steelhead trout on the beautiful waters of the Kasilof River with these two fly fishing pros.
Oh, yeah!
All right.
Awesome.
What a big old beast.
75 yards.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Minnesota Power, Team SmackDown Outdoors, Meyer Recreational Buildings, and Canada Outdoor Adventures.
Environmental stewardship runs deep at Minnesota Power. We value clean air and water while delivering safe, reliable, and affordable electricity that enhances your comfort, security, and quality of life. Minnesota Power, powering the pace
of industry,
of business,
of life.
Team SmackDown Outdoors. Team SmackDown Outdoors, leading the way in custom outdoor art.
At Meyer Recreational Buildings, you'll get a certified building experience where we assure you a worry-free, guaranteed, high-quality recreational building. Designed by outdoorsmen like you, Meyer Recreational Buildings are built with the highest quality American-made materials. Build with confidence. Build with Meyer.
My name is Jeff Meyer from Meyer Recreational Buildings. Call me today for a better way to build.
Visit our website at MeyerRecreational.com and pick out your design today.
Offering professionally guided, all-inclusive packages, Canada Outdoor Adventures is a U.S.-based company specializing in great hunting adventures in Alberta, British Columbia, New Zealand, and beyond. Whether you're seeking that trophy of a lifetime, planning a hunt for you or your group, or taking your son or daughter on their first adventure, let Canada Outdoor Adventures handle all the details for you. To contact a pro staff member near you, visit our website. Canada Outdoor Adventures, the adventure of a lifetime.
Hi everyone, welcome to Outdoor Bound TV. I'm your host, Kurt Walbeck. Paul Tornow and Lee Kuepper graduated from the same high school in northern Wisconsin without knowing that each shared a dream to become professional fly fishermen on one of Alaska's last frontiers, the Kenai River. But a chance meeting in a bar in southern Alaska a few years ago changed all that. When the two Manakwa natives reunited, they learned of each other's passion for fly fishing and together created Alaska's angling addiction. Let's head to Alaska's Kenai River Peninsula right now.
Today we're out here on the Kasilof River, which is about halfway down the Kenai Peninsula up here in Alaska. We're fishing the spring steelhead run, but we're fishing the confluence here of Crooked Creek and Kasilof River. And what happens is the steelhead come up in the spring, and they'll come up and run into the Crooked Creek here. And we'll also get male steelhead, which came in the fall, and they'll come down and they kind of meet right here at this little area. You can actually see the color difference in the river there behind us. But how we're gonna fish them today is we're gonna be swinging flies. Here I got a spey rod I like to cast with, or you can use a single hand as well. But we're gonna be swinging a sculpin or a leech pattern. Generally, it's a pretty natural presentation in these fish because of where we are and proximity to other places. It gets kind of pressured sometimes, so toning down your baits using something more natural tends to work a lot better. This one here is a little mini sculpin that I make. It's black and it's got a red dorsal fin. But really what we're looking for are these two little transition zones. You can see kind of behind us that point of the water where the Kasilof River meets Crooked Creek here, and it's kind of a nice spot to swing flies. We'll also be working upriver a little ways and finding little eddies and pockets behind these big boulders and little divots in the bottom of the river where these fish like to hold up. We'll also be casting some egg patterns, indicators and beads and different kinds of flies like a Gorman egg. And these just imitate, really it's just an attractor, really doesn't imitate very much besides an egg, but for some reason the vast majority of steelhead, wherever you go, are attracted to those egg patterns all year long. So we'll see how it goes. He wants to go right up with me here, you know?
You want to come?
Got lucky out here. We've been kind of steelhead fishing, but it's a really nice little hen here. The female, you can tell by her, doesn't have a big kype on her jaw. They're nice pretty colors, and took the black sculpin pattern. She's about ready to go for the release here, huh? Alright baby, go back and make me some more steelhead here. Whew, fingers are cold now.
Alright buddy. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Paul Tornow from Soldotna, Alaska. I grew up in northern Wisconsin in Boulder Junction. I wanted to be a fishing guide, so I came up here right after high school. I saved up all summer long and drove up in the winter. And then the following summer, I ended up getting out on a halibut boat and getting a beer after a long day of guiding one day and at this little restaurant called The Sunrise in Cooper Landing. And look down at the end of the bar, and sure enough, here this guy is, just randomly sitting there having a beer. And I'm like, what the heck? What are you doing here, man?
So I was grabbing a burger and happened to look across the bar and saw a face that was kind of familiar. Now I was kind of scratching my head, trying to pinpoint exactly what it was. And it happened to be a guy I went to high school with back in Minocqua at Lakeland.
And so go over there, buy him beer, sit, start swapping stories and catch up on all, you know, what we had been doing for the last few years. And we started kind of talking a little bit about possibly getting together and running something on our own and doing it kind of our way. And
so that kind of relationship developed, and through that, after the next couple of years, we decided we wanted to start our own business and actually run things how we thought things should be ran as far as the trips and how we're actually showing people Alaska, because it really, Alaska left an impression on us, and we want to leave that exact same impression on people that come up here to visit.
So Lee and I started Alaska's Angling Addiction, and some of the things that we do, I think a little differently than most other companies, is we offer like the teaching aspect that goes along with fishing.
Paul and I are both certified casting instructors, and really teaching people on how to fish, especially if you're a beginner, fly fishing is pretty intense. So when we get out under the water, there's a lot of demonstration and instruction involved in getting you to the point where you can efficiently cast and catch fish. And even if you're an intermediate caster, we can make your loops better and make your casting even more efficient than what you were before. And also just kind of teach you a lot about what we're going to be doing, why we're doing it, and how we're going to be doing it, I think is really important to teach people when you're out on the water, as opposed to just being out on the water for 8 hours saying, do this. I want you to know why, so when you leave, you're a better angler. And that's really the premise behind our whole guide business, is to have you coming away as a better angler, as well as having a fantastic day on the water. You know, Alaska really left an impression on me just due to the fact that it's just so wild. There's very few places that I've been that there's really not much private property. If you want to go to the top of that mountain, you can go to the top of the mountain. If you want to go fish that river, you can generally go fish that river. And that kind of wildness and the free spirit of Alaska is really an amazing draw, and obviously the fishing is pretty good consequently too.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Mission by Matthews, True Fire Releases, Tacticam, and G2 Outdoor Products.
This is my life, the weekend warrior. No more production lines or deadlines. This is why I work 5 days a week. I need speed, power, precision. I expect no less than the best. This is my best. This is my chance. This is my mission.
Simple, efficient, powerful. Mission by Matthews.
Well, Mark, I gotta hand it to you. I am loving my True Fire Hardcore.
I wouldn't steer you wrong, brother.
Not only is this thing extremely accurate on the range, its features are deadly in the field.
What I noticed, whether you're sweating shooting does in the early season or shivering when that late season buck comes in, that jaw cannot come off that loop. I love my True Fire Hardcore.
Wait, what do you got there?
That's a hardcore forefinger.
Give me that.
Not this time, brother.
The True Fire Hardcore, available at your local retailer.
Ben, what do you have on the front of your bow?
This is the new Tacticam HD video camera and bow stabilizer, all in one. It features one-touch easy recording in a waterproof housing, and it comes with universal mounting with a rechargeable battery.
Film your hunt hands-free in full HD.
That's incredible. Where do you find those?
Tacticam is available to purchase on our website or at an outdoor retailer near you. Tacticam, share your hunt.
Hey everyone, we love to see the photos of the animals you harvest and the fish you catch here on Outdoor Bound TV. Well, this season, our friends at Petrick Service Station have once again teamed up with Mike Liga Taxidermy to bring you some great prizes just for submitting your photos to the show.
Simply log on to the Outdoor Bound TV website, click on the Submit Photo button, and all the instructions and contest rules are right there. All animal photos submitted will be entered into the Hunting Grand Prize Drawing, a Remington Model 700 270 rifle, compliments of Petrick Service Station. All fish photos submitted will be entered into the Fishing Grand Prize Drawing, a professional fish mounting, compliments of Mike Liga Taxidermy. All entries must be received by December 1st to qualify.
And remember, you can't win if you don't submit your photos.
Here are this week's Outdoor Bound TV viewer photos.
Today we're going to be drifting the entirety of the Kasilof River, which starts up at Tustamina Lake, which is a big glacier-fed body of water. We're going to be floating from the headwaters right up at the lake all the way down almost to where we fished before at Crooked Creek. And we're going to see if we can find some fish holding throughout the water. It's about a 12 to 14 mile float, so it's a long one. It'll last the majority of the day. But I think we'll be able to find some fish scattered in and out, moving either to and from the places where they're going to end up spawning here in a couple weeks.
All right, guys. Well, today we're on the upper stretches of the Kasilof River up by Tustamina Lake where the headwaters are. We're going to be floating about 13 miles of the river today. What we're going to be fishing for is steelhead. They kind of migrate in and out from the salt water, and then some are coming out of the streams that come out of the lake, some of the tributaries, and then they're backing out, spawning through here, finishing up with that. And we're trying to hook up with some of the fresher hens that are coming up from the salt water. And the way we're going to be doing that is with one of the ways we're going to be doing that is with spinner rods to try and just locate fish right off the bat, because we got a lot of water, with plugs, and we'll be back trolling them out in the current just with the rod holders. And what they do is with these plugs, we get it down in there and they're more or less a intruder type of pattern where they aggravate the fish. It comes into wherever it's hanging out, feeding, and the fish gets irritated with the smaller bait fish, either the color. Sometimes it helps irritate them, but then they grab a hold of it, and what we're hoping happens is they grab it long enough to where they turn downstream and then kind of impale themselves, hook themselves on the side. And so we just got to be patient when they take it, just slowly start taking the rod. And what we're really looking for is just pull out gunnel slams, what we call them. The rod is just corked and the line ripping off the reel. Sometimes they'll just come up and start pecking at it, and that's them coming up and hitting the side, bumping it, nuzzling it, and you're just getting all ready, and you just got to wait. And a lot of times they'll come back 2-3 times and before they just take it, turn sideways with it. So with any luck, maybe we'll get a couple of takedowns today on these and a few on the fly rods.
There's the fish. Reel that one in. Oh, you lost him? Is he there?
He's there. He's there. Reel that one in.
Or just give it to Kurt. Lift it.
Here,
up,
give it to me.
Above.
Give it to me.
Okay, I got you. Go ahead.
He's going upstream to the right.
Go around.
Okay. He's under this rod over here.
Okay, you're under both of them. So you'll be okay.
Okay, it's okay.
Go ahead and pull the other ones up. Give that one to Kurt, Paul.
Got it.
Okay.
He's under both of them. I was gonna jump on the back of that rock. I jumped that other boulder.
That's a big fish.
Oh, it's a toad.
Yeah, it's a big one.
I think he's just going upstream.
Whoa, whoa. Look at that. Jeez.
Good tail. Good tail.
Look at the tail on that thing!
Wear out. There aren't too many big boulders out there. Oh!
It just came unbuttoned. Just came right up.
Wasn't that a big fish?
Oh!
I let that one go a little early.
Professional release.
Professional release, long distance release. We were just coming down this chute right here and working both sides of the seam of the fast water. We had plug rods kind of working those seams and then also a couple working the inside seams in the fast water. And the one that was on the inside by the big boulders just hit a fish, basically. Fish hit it, it irritated it, took it downstream and ran us around the river a little bit. Kind of did the Chinese fire drill there, moving rods around, and we got to see it a few times and
it's a somber experience, okay?
Yes, it is.
So depending on what kind of water we're going to be fishing when we're floating down the Kasilof here, we choose a couple different methods and we have a couple different kinds of rods in the boat. If we do find a run or a tailout that looks really, really good, we'll actually pull out what we call plug rods that have little, almost like little crankbaits on the back, and we'll back row the drift boat and kind of slowly shift these plugs back and forth across a really fishy looking water in hopes of finding some of these steelhead. The main one we'll be employing is probably fishing with the fly rod, drifting egg patterns down alongside of the boat while we're drifting down the river.
Well, folks, this is what you come to Alaska for. Awesome steelhead fishing with Alaska's angling addiction. Paul and Lee have put us on some awesome fishing this week, and I tell you what, nowhere can you go and catch steelhead like this with beautiful scenery. Just incredible, incredible time up here. And if you want to come up and give it a try, we have Paul and Lee's phone number and website information on the screen. Please come up and give this a whirl. This has just been incredible. It's tough to explain. The scenery here is wonderful, and the fishing, well, I guess it kind of speaks for itself. Absolutely incredible here in Alaska. You got to come up and give this a try. Thanks, buddy.
Really, I think drew Paul and I to the Kenai Peninsula is just the diversity that the entire area has. There's mountains, there's tundra, caribou, moose, eagles, there's saltwater. The Kenai Peninsula really gives you all of Alaska for the most part that usually you can't find in one particular place.
Coming from Wisconsin, growing up there, you think of Wisconsin as just this unbelievable place to kind of grow up as a kid and be able to, you know, hunt in the evening for whitetails in the evening, go out, do some fishing for muskies, walleye, bass.
I can give away just the majority of the salmon throughout the year, but if I had a walleye in my hands, man, I'd like tackle a guy for it right now.
We've got all these sport fish that you can go for, and it's almost like a breeding ground for something bigger and greater, something like this.
As much as I miss Wisconsin and the Midwest and everything that it offered, Alaska is definitely now home and will be for the foreseeable future.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Real Deal Mineral, Weiss Realty, Chilson Automotive, and MBS.
Real Deal Mineral. Deer eat it gone.
Real Deal Mineral is the real deal. It contains less than 7% salt and more of the minerals deer need for proper gestation. And
it's a great way to ensure that your deer are getting the proper vitamins and minerals they need to grow big horns.
We started using Real Deal Mineral on our farm this year, and the results, well, they speak for themselves.
Real Deal Mineral. Check out our website or a dealer near you.
Hi, I'm Gordy Weiss, owner of Weiss Realty. Let me help you find your dream property today. Let's take a look at this week's featured listing.
This incredible 240 acres in Wisconsin's Rush River Valley features several food plots, water holes, and ATV access trails. A combination of fertile soil and oak ridges hold many trophy caliber animals.
Whether you're interested in buying or selling a property, give me a call today.
Is shopping for a used car getting you down?
Where to look? Where did it come from? Is it a good car?
Well, look no further than the Chilson family of dealerships.
All of our certified vehicles include a vehicle history report, a thorough safety inspection by our certified technicians, a warranty at no cost, and two keys just in case. Call, click, or visit any one of our three friendly family dealerships.
For the largest selection in the area and the easiest buying experience around.
And always, let our family take care of your family.
Since 1999, McCuffsky Brush Service has been specializing in right-of-way clearing for power, gas, fiber optic, cable lines, and railroads. MBS is your complete brush and tree removal company, and we also clear woods, roads, and food plots. Whether working on residential tree trimming or commercial projects, MBS utilizes the most advanced equipment and environmentally friendly clearing methods available. MBS, clearing the way to reliable energy. Visit our website for more information.
Archery equipment provided for Outdoor Bound TV by Mission by Matthews, True Fire Releases, Optimizer by HHA Sports, and Tacticam.
You know, Lee is exactly right. Alaska truly does have everything in the outdoors. It was a pleasure to get to spend a few days with these two Midwest natives on the water of the Kenai River Peninsula, and not only get to see their appreciation of their Midwest heritage, but also their excitement for the place they now call home. Folks, join us again here next week when we'll bring you more great hunting and fishing action from around the Midwest, around the nation, and around the world, right here on Outdoor Bound TV.
I'm the keeper. I live in a gravel pit.
Hello, I'm Paul Tornow.
I'm the Kenai Peninsula.
I grew up in...
We're fishing with Alaska's...
Angling addiction.
Yeah.
Here in Kenai, on the Kenai Peninsula.
Yeah, that's me.
Outdoor Bound TV.
What the heck was I just talking about?
Too many things.
Did you get that one?
One more time, I'll get you.